says, I forgive my debtors. I'm not going to be indebted to somebody in the way of unforgiveness. The only thing that I'm going to be indebted to my neighbor is to love them. Somebody shout yes. I got to love them unconditionally. I got to love them because the Bible tells me to love and to forgive. And then watch this. The Bible goes on to say something. It says, and lead us not into temptation. Watch this. The Lord laid something on my heart concerning that forgiveness. Yes. Amen. Because what God is saying here, the Lord gave me a revelation here where it says, and lead us not into temptation. One of the things God says that we are, our prayers not only in response of trouble, but it should be in advance of trouble.
Yeah.
Amen. We should not be, we should be proactive and not just reactive. So in other words, what Jesus is saying, lead us not into temptation, it means that you need to be praying so that God will not allow what the enemy is bringing your way to come your way. Because so many times we are praying in response of trouble, but you need to learn to be proactive. You need to learn, amen, that I'm going to pray and God gives me the sermon so I can get it all that mess. Can I get a witness in the house? Lead us not into temptation. So I'm going to pray because I know God knows what's down the road. He knows what's around the corner. He knows that the enemy is wishing my demise. But God has a plan. Somebody shout, God's plan. God has a plan. And so when I pray and I seek God's face, he'll lead me around the trouble. Somebody shout, yes. So many times we get in a mess and then we pray. But God said, pray before you get in a mess. Somebody shout, yes. Somebody shout, yes. Somebody shout, yes. I'm going to pray. There's some demons around the corner. I'm gonna pray because I know there's some trouble down the road. But my God knows the ending from the beginning. He knows the trouble is down the road. So I'm gonna pray to God, lead me not into temptation. He knows how much I can bear, and he knows that whatever I praise, he'll make everything all right. God is saying, I just need you to pray. I just need you to call on my name. But I got to hurt with this. I want you to know something. Not only is prayer, amen, consists of relationship, but it also, amen, requires our persistence. Somebody shout persistence. What do I mean by that? What I mean is that we have here a parable that the Lord Jesus was sharing, because in the parable there was a man, amen, that was bombarded at midnight, amen, and said, well, there's somebody at my house, but I don't have enough to give them. Can you help me out? So this person in turn went to a friend, but the friend was asleep, and he resisted for a while, but he decided, because of his persistence, I'm going to get up and give him everything that he needs. Somebody shout yes. We serve a holy God. We serve a righteous God, and they expect us to keep on praying. The Bible says ask, but you got to keep on seeking God. Somebody shout yes. But watch this. In Isaiah 62, 6 and 7, I want you to write it down. Isaiah 62, the 6th and the 7th verse, it says, basically, ye that make mention of the Lord, keep not silent and give him, that is God, no rest till he establish.
All right.
It says, give him no rest In other words, just like this parable that we just read, where the person was asleep. You know, God never slumbers nor sleep. It was just a parable, but it's trying to say that you just keep seeking the Lord. Don't worry about the time. It could be at midnight. It could be at 3 o'clock in the morning. It doesn't matter. But I'm going to seek the Lord. I'm going to be persistent.
Yes, sir.
And calling on the Lord. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But then lastly, not only should we be persistent, but we've got to make sure that we are confident in the Lord. Because how in the world, we are evil, know how to give good gifts to our children, how much more should our Heavenly Father give good things, in this case, the Holy Ghost, but it means anything that you need in the Lord, God will do it. The Bible says in 1 John 5:14, this is the confidence that we have in Him, that if we ask anything according to His He heareth us, and if we know He hears us, whatever we ask, we have the petitions that we desire of Him. Somebody shout hallelujah. Wave your hand in the house of God. Let the Lord know I'm confident that you're going to shower me with the blessings from on high as I seek your face and seek you. And seek you. The blessings of God will come upon my life. Somebody shout yes. Evil men know how to give good gifts to their children.